What is up everybody, Golden Holden here, and today we are going to be using Copper Strike to play onto some steel using the Universal Plater. What we are going to be plating today is this machined steel part, and we are going to be using the Copper Strike and plating it with 24K gold. To get this prepared, I'm going to be taping off sections so we can see the difference between using a Woods Nickel Strike and no Woods Nickel Strike in the process of plating this. All right, so I've gotten all masked and taped off, and we are going to go into plating it. All right, so we are going to start off with our electro clean, but first we're going to just see the difference between it being wetted out and it not wetting out. So if we zoom in, this is it not wetted out. It's all beading up, and we need it to be the opposite of it, where the water is sticking to it. So we will use the electro clean to do that right now, and I'm just going to clamp our clip to it. This is our common lead, and this is our electro clean. I'm going to just plate it like that. And I can tell it's working because there is bubbles forming on the surface. And we'll just go around this for about, I'd say, a minute to 2 minutes at 7 volts. And this should be good. All right, so now we are going to test if our electroclean did its job properly. So this is the side we electro cleaned, and this isn't. So we'll spray this, and if the water doesn't stick to it, like beads up like it is on this tape right here, we are good. And it is doing it. So this will be good to copper strike next. And you can tell this is it not electro cleaned. So now we are going to go in the process of copper striking it. So I'm going to turn our voltage down to 3.5, and I'll get our copper strike, and I do need to plug it in. There we go. So I'll get our copper strike, and I'll start plating our area. This does take a little bit of time to plate onto it. So, yeah, but you can see it starting to plate onto it. The reason to use copper strike is because it's a visual aid to see your part is activated properly before you plate it with the nickel. The copper strike is soft enough so it is easy to remove if there's an issue, unlike the nickel that is harder to remove when you do have an issue. It also helps prevent oxidization in the metal, and the copper strike is very similar to Tri-Val in the way as it prepares the surface and has a visual aid so you can tell your part has been activated. But the copper strike is the cheaper option, so that's why it is good to use the copper strike. All right, so I have plated this in the copper strike, and it is looking good. And I'll spray it off. And the next step now is to plate it with the nickel. The next step now is to plate our item with nickel, and I'll just keep it at the same voltage as the copper. And I actually plugged it into this port where the copper was. And we'll get into plating it. You can see it's starting to turn that silvery color instead of the copper. All right, so I've gotten this nickel applied to our part. You can see it's nice and silver again. And we're gonna go in with the gold and start plating it with the gold. And I'll keep it at the same voltage. This is our 24 karat gold, so I'm gonna just keep it at 3.5 5-ish volts. Look at that, apply. We'll zoom in. Look how good this part looks now that I've plated it with the gold. So I electro-cleaned it, put the copper strike on it, nickel-plated it, and then put the gold on it. The reason why we use the copper strike is because, one, it visually helps you see if you're activating it properly, just like the tri-valve, but the copper is less expensive than the tri-valve. The next good thing about it is it's very soft, so if there is a part that hasn't been activated on your part properly, then you can polish it off without having to take it to a polishing wheel. You can get our mother's mag and just wipe it off with the mother's mag, and it's a lot easier to fix instead of the nickel, where the nickel is harder to polish off and get off your parts. Now, the next step in this process, I'm going to actually plate this side and use the wood nickel strike in this process as an add-on, just so we can see the difference if you don't use it and if you do use it. So just like before, we are going to need to use that electroclean and prevent it from beading on the metal. So let's do that right now. All right, and just like that, it is not beading anymore, unlike this. See the difference in that? You can see the difference in it beading and not beading. Now, the next step I'm going to do is getting our Woods nickel, and I'm gonna keep it at the same voltage as the electroclean, just 7 volts. You can see it's working because it's bubbling. And we're just going to go over this really quickly and not overdo it. All right, that whole piece has been activated. Now I have to switch out this and put in our copper strike. Let's move all these cords out of the way. Rinse off your part. We're going to get this copper. We're going to need to plate it at 3.5 volts. That's what I like just with this piece. We'll start plating it. There we go, you can see it starting to show up. So now visually, I can see that this is getting plated properly with that copper strike. So I'll rinse it off and we'll switch out our copper strike with our nickel. Put the nickel in, and we'll start plating it with the nickel and watch it change. Look at that, all the copper is going away with the nickel because we are plating nickel on top of the copper. All right, now we've got it plated in our nickel. I'll spray it off and rinse it. And now we can move on to our gold. So we'll get our gold and watch this. Watch it start appearing. Make sure to get down here. Do a little rolling. There you go. It's showing up now. There we go. Look at that. And just like that, our part is plated in gold. So this is our second plating job on that side. And this is our first. And I'm gonna go rinse it off and let it sit for a second. And then we can peel off the tape and see what side looks better. All right, so I've let this part sit for a little bit after I've washed it off, and now we are going to peel the tape up. So this is our Woods nickel side and our regular plating side. The Woods nickel is preference. It's just an option. If you have it, it's always good to activate it and make sure it's properly activated. The copper strike does activate your part, so you don't need to activate it. I just personally like to make sure that I have activated it. So we'll peel off the tape. So there's our part. And visually, they look identical in the camera. This one in real life is a little more orange than this one. This one has a more yellow tint to it, and this is our Woods nickel. They both look good and pretty good result. If you guys are interested in getting the copper strike solution for brush plating, you can go to our website and purchase it there. And if you have any questions, you can also check us out on our website and contact us. And I hope you guys enjoyed this video and have a great day.